But Mike and Visit SAC identified one major gap in our tourism strategy. We aren't attracting major youth sports tournaments and other events, and thus not getting the hotel rooms, because we don't have the facility. And as I said, other regions do. I mean, Placer County to Spokane, Manteca to San Jose, Fresno to Las Vegas. Here's what happens. Kids, Sacramento kids and families must travel to compete. And when they do, those families stay in other cities' hotels and boost other cities' tax bases. No more! No more! Belongs in Sacramento. So, this is not just some idea off the top of my head, because last year, Mike and Visit SAC engaged national experts to give us a real idea of what could such a regional sports facility look like. There are so many options and so many models, and I don't have a preferred idea. That's for the community and for the tourism experts and for everybody to figure out. But, you know, you can do indoor sports, basketball, you can do track, supercross, you name it. But here's one lead idea that popped off the page for me in the report. Imagine 24 full-size multi-use fields, 16 natural grass, 8 artificial turf, a championship field of 2,000 permanent seats, lighting for all fields, locker room, meeting spaces, and food facilities. I told you it's 102 acres out there. This facility would require 40 to 50 acres, leaving over half of the remaining 102 acres for other economic drivers or other community amenities. And what is its approximate cost? $50 million. You say, come on, 50, it's a tough time. Where are we gonna get $50 million? I'm gonna give you that answer in a moment. Regional, state, and national tournaments would get booked 15 to 20 times a year, about 30% of the time. You know what that would mean? 70% of the time, the facility would be the pride and possession of our city and the community. The nexus between tourism and a transformational project like this is crystal clear. Here's what they tell us. Such a project would attract 70,000 attendees per year, $28 million a year in visitor spending, 51,000 hotel nights, $3.5 million in total tax collections. What a dream. And so you're saying to yourself, that's a nice dream. But we all know a dream stays a dream unless you have a credible way to pay for it. And I'm here to tell you today, we have a way to pay for it. When we expanded the Community Convention Center and built the new Community Center Theater, we had the hotel tax and the hoteliers assess themselves to build a third floor ballroom. That left an extra $50 million in hotel taxes to improve and modernize the old Sacramento waterfront. Man, was I excited about that, and I still am. But then COVID hit, and the money dried up as the hotel occupancy obviously went down. But we're not fully back, but we're almost back. Hotel occupancy has largely recovered. And so we took it to very conservative financial experts. Thank you. Always, John Colville, always looking out for the city's bottom line, rightfully so. Conservative. And guess what John and CBRE told us? They told us that beginning July 1, 2024, a mere 24 months from now, absent another pandemic or disaster, God forbid, we will be able to afford another $90 to $100 million for projects that boost tourism and hotel nights in our city. $90 to $100 million. Without Mike Testa raising the hotel tax another penny. And he's clapping big time there. Now, hotel taxes, they can't be used for housing, for public safety, or for general services. But a big regional sports complex that serves the community and also is a magnet for tourism, that also serves as a large public assembly space, fits the purpose of the hotel tax perfectly. And we wouldn't be alone. Cities throughout the country have used their hotel tax to build these facilities, and we should do the same here in Sacramento. So here's the opportunity. If the city, Visit SAC, and the community get started now with design, with planning, and with all the other necessary steps to build an iconic regional sports facility in South Sacramento. We could break ground in 2024 and realize this dream before half the decade is out. Instead of merely planning for years and hoping for some fiscal breakthrough later in the decade. You know what I believe. Let's go. Dream it. Design it. Build it. Look what we did with the Golden One Center, the Kings and Mark and everybody. We can do it in South Sacramento. And we can do it without raising a tax. And I will say, as a footnote, that if the sports facility requires $50 million, and we have the capacity then to raise 90 to 100, as I said earlier, maybe, just maybe, we'll have enough capacity to build both the sports complex and modernize the old Sacramento waterfront. Wouldn't that be something? But first and last, our young people. I want every Sacramento kid, now and in the generations to come, to look back after 50 years, like I do, and have those same great memories of games, of friends, and experiences, lifelong memories. And so we're going to do it. Councilmember Vang and I will bring a resolution to the City Council this summer. And with the blessing of our colleagues and the help of the entire city team and the community, we will get started on delivering maybe our biggest prize yet in our drive, our city drive, to leave no part of Sacramento behind. Thank you very much, everybody.